Hello there, Minecraft friends. My name is Alaydriem, and welcome back to another Minecraft Bedrock tutorial with your favorite cardigan-wearing Minecraft character. And in today's Minecraft Bedrock tutorial, I'll be showing you how to make this potato-powered XP bank that you can use to gather both XP for all your crafting and repairing and enchanting needs, but also get more baked potatoes than you find at a church Sunday potluck. Now, before we get into the tutorial, I want to talk a little bit about how this farm works and what its mechanics are. And this farm is dead simple. It consists of just four farmer villagers who all day, every day, do nothing but plant and fashion good old-fashioned spuds. And because they're such generous folk, they share what they harvest with a few hungry villagers here in the middle of the farm. Now, the setup of this farm prevents them from ever getting access to any of the potatoes their friends toss them, and then taters are sucked straight down into a smoker system where they're cooked up just like your great-grandma used to make, whereafter they're sucked into a storage chest, leaving us with the sour cream on top, a tasty collection of XP. Now, as long as these villagers are kept inside of a loaded chunk, they will continue to harvest them tubers for you, giving you thousands upon thousands of them tasty treats to eat, and plenty of XP to use for the complete repair of all your armor or tools or for use in enchanting setup. And that's about it. There is not a lot that goes into this farm, so let's go ahead and get into the tutorial. Now to get started, you're going to want to carve out a 19 by 19 area inclusive of this outer border here. I recommend using wool or some other type of marker to fill that in. Mark the center and then bring that line right into the dead center of the farm. And then from that center point, you're going to want to put a double chest on each axis. This is where our potato storage is going to ultimately filter down to. On top of those double chests, go ahead and add yourself some hoppers feeding into that and install some smokers on top of each of those hoppers. We'll configure these hoppers later so that we can toggle them on and off and have a little bit more control. Now on the side of each of these smokers, you're going to want to place a hopper feeding into it. We'll use this to store our fuel source. You can use lava or kelp or really whatever you want, whatever burns good. On top of each of these smokers, add a single layer of hoppers and then add a repeater pointing into one of those hoppers. I recommend that you point this the same direction that your side hoppers are pointing into, just because that'll help you keep track of which feeding system points to which. It'll just help keep organized later. And then we're going to want to stack a set of blocks up and then knock that bottom block up right beside that, feeding into that, and pop a lever in. Now, this lever will be used to control the flow of potatoes going into our hopper so that when the system is fully charged up and full, we can basically turn it off and prevent additional potatoes from being cooked. Then we can just toggle the lever on and off for a couple seconds, and that will bring in new potatoes for us to cook and smelt and extract XP from. Just do a quick test over here to make sure that all of your levers and repeaters are working. Moving on up, you're going to want to place a single chest on top of each of those hoppers feeding into your smoker. This just gives us some extra storage space to feed those spuds in. And then on top of each chest, you're going to want to place two hoppers feeding into that. Again, this is just to give us a lot more space to work with. Now, get some grass blocks, and you're going to want to, off that second hopper right above the chest, bring out a line on both sides of it all the way out to the edge of your farm, not to over the line, but directly to where that border is. Then, once you have that done on all four sides, bring a line of grass blocks out from the chest that you place all the way to the edge of the farm. And then we're going to want to fill in this area in a circle pattern. What I recommend you do is fill in that middle channel, fill in a block on each side, and then go two blocks in, knock out the corner block, then add one corner block in between them. So you should have 5, 2, 1, 2, 5, if you can visualize that pattern. And of course, once you have all of the edges built in, go ahead and fill in the entire farm with the exception of that initial channel that we built with grass blocks. This will be the tillable area of our farm that our farmers will use to plant all of our potatoes. Next, either over the east, west, or north, south directions, we're going to want to add two blocks at the end of the farm here. These will serve as platforms for a bed that we'll place in here that'll keep our villagers nice and safe so that they can sleep. And then you want to go ahead and just knock out that extra block. And then once you have your farmland laid out, you're going to want to fill in these little channels we have with water. You can go ahead and just make an infinite water source, but these channels, if you fill in 3 blocks, you basically have an infinite water source there for you to use. Then move into the center next to these hoppers and place down a single slab that our villagers will use to hop onto to toss food in. Next, we're going to want to create a barricade around our farm. You can do this by using any type of block you want. Just circle the entire edge of the farm with blocks and then stack those up 3 blocks high. This will ensure that our villagers can't jump out of the farm and will make sure that nothing can get in. Here I'm using glass just because it's really convenient, helps me see in the farm, helps you guys see in the farm. You can use cobblestone, you can use sandstone, you can use dirt blocks if you want, whatever you're comfortable with, use whatever block you'd like. Now on the inside of the farm, you're going to want to build up a barrier 3 blocks high. You're going to want to do this over each of the water channels. This will keep our 4 villagers separated and will prevent them from crossing over. It'll prevent them from breeding with each other and creating little baby villagers. And it will allow each of them to throw potatoes to the villager that we're going to place here in the center of the farm. Go ahead and do-si-do right back on over to the center of our farm. And in the middle here, level with the top of these chests, place down a full block that's going to be level with the top of the chest. Next, you're going to want to crouch click down on top of each of these hoppers and place down 2 rows of fence posts. These fence posts will prevent our villager from being able to grab anything that's on the hoppers and will keep him from having his inventory filled up. And then finally here in the center, go ahead and waterlog that block. Moving on to the villager section of our farm, go ahead in each of these alcoves and place down a bed. And then in the corner of the farm where there's just these little 1x1 blocks, go ahead and place down a composter and then move a villager in. Now, your villager should automatically link to the composter and the bed, but if for some reason he links to the smokers down here, go ahead and just knock those smokers out and he will relink. We'll go ahead and re-add those later if you do have any troubles. And then also, if for some reason you got water down here because you misclicked or clicked a couple times, you can just add a slab or a block there. Next, we're going to want to repeat this process in each quadrant of our circle here. Now, it's really important that you only add 1 bed, 1 composter, and 1 villager at a time. That will ensure that they stay locked into the quadrant they're in and will prevent them from trying to walk over to other quadrants. If you place down too many villagers and they link to the wrong bed, instead of farming, they'll try to jump over this fence, which they obviously can't do, and the farm will not be as efficient as it could be. Next, back here in the middle of the farm, you're going to want to drop a villager down. Now, the easiest way to do this in survival is to place a block above him like I did, drive a boat on top of the villager, and then cut the boat down in the block. He should just fall straight into that hole. If he doesn't, you can just nudge him in. But once you have that villager in place, you can pop a block on top of him, and then you can farm out all of this area and then give each of your villagers just a stack of potatoes so that they can get going. And as you can see here, once they have that stack of potatoes, they just start farming right away like there's no tomorrow. Now, because villagers in Minecraft Bedrock can at times be persnickety and decide to vanish off the face of the earth with no trace of their existence whatsoever, what I recommend you do is craft a couple of name tags, just call them farmer, and then give each of those villagers a name tag. Additionally, go ahead and get that stack of emeralds you've been hoarding and do an initial trade with them to get them over that level 1. Those 2 things should prevent the villagers from despawning. Finally, go over here with a light block source of any kind. You can use torches, you can use sea lanterns, you can use pumpkins, whatever you have available, and just fill in this top row with lights so that when it becomes night, or if you have this in a cave, your farm is still productive. Now, the next part of this farm is certainly the trickiest. You have to wait. Your farmers are going to harvest all of these potatoes, and then when they see this poor little villager in the middle, they'll walk over to it and throw it some potatoes. And because that farmer can't reach anything, those potatoes will be sucked into our system. However, we need to have this potato farm fully charged up. And what I mean by that is we need that double chest at the bottom that was the first thing we placed and the hopper beneath our smoker fully filled up with baked potatoes. So let this farm run, go ahead and work on one of your builds or anything else, and after a couple of hours, you should have a fully loaded chest and hopper of potatoes. Again, it is really important that you allow this double chest and the hopper beneath the smoker to completely fill up. That's how we charge all of our XP. But as you can see here, once our farmers get going, oh, do they produce potatoes. Now, once you've let this farm run for long enough, it'll eventually be completely filled up to the brim with potatoes. Now, in order to use this farm and extract the XP from it, we're first going to want to lock each of these hoppers, take out the uncooked potatoes in each of the smokers, and then in this bottom chest here, pull out a full stack of potatoes. That will allow the potatoes that are currently in the smoker to be pulled through the system without any of the XP being pulled out from it as well. And of course, now the fun part of this, go ahead and put on all your broken armor or whatever you need, and then go up to a locked smoker. Once all of the potatoes are fully drained out of it, go ahead and add about 6 or 8 potatoes. 6 should be enough to fully repair netherite armor. And then let those potatoes cook. You're going to want to take out each potato once it's done, and that will give you a ton of XP. And if you are using mending armor, that should very, very, very quickly have all of your armor fully repaired. Now, I did a little goof here and started out with 58 levels from another part of the video I was doing just to test this. But as you can see, that's 58 levels just from 6 or 8 potatoes. Going here, I went from 58 to 73 levels very quickly, and with just 6 potatoes, fully mended armor. That's all that it took. And of course, no new potatoes will fall in, but if you do need more XP for whatever reason, just give that lever a little swish on the side. 4 or 5 potatoes should drop in, then you can just grab those as they come through. This farm between the 4 smokers you have should last you a very long time, but if for any reason you start to see this farm start to slow down and produce even less, go ahead and just take some potatoes out of those bottom chests and then let some new ones recook. And of course, there's dozens of uses for all those potatoes you made. You can eat them, you can throw them into a composter to make bone meal, really you can do whatever. But that's all the time we have for today. I hope you enjoyed this farm. If you did find this farm useful and end up using it, go ahead and give this video a like and consider subscribing. It really does help the channel. Anyway, that's all I have for you today. Thank you so much for watching, and I will see you next time. Bye.